Hello friends, welcome to Quick Learn tutorial series. In this video, I will explain you PLC programming and this is part 1 of PLC programming series. So let's start with the topic. So in this video, before I discuss about PLC programming, first I will give you a brief introduction of what do you mean by programming language. So any programming language provide some commands, grammar and syntax. Syntax means the format for instructing any digital devices and computers to perform a specific task. So if we want to control any device, if we want to perform a particular task from a particular device, these programming language give some command and give some instruction through which that device get perform the specific task. So in this way, we also program PLC because we know that PLC is basically a microprocessor based controlling system. It is a controller that can program according to the given logic. So we can say that PLC is basically a user programmable device that is used to control a specific task. So here I written programmable logic controller are the controller hub for a wide variety of automated system and process. PLC is basically used for industrial automation, for control and any machine function or production line. So we can say that PLC is basically used for industrial controlling system. And we know that PLC use wide variety of inputs and output and provide network capability. So PLC programming is a crucial task because it having wide variety of inputs and outputs of implementing and design control application as per the user requirement. Because we know that PLC is a user programmable device. So we can program PLC according to the application. So in PLC, we give set of instructions in the form of graphical or textual form, which is used to perform a control task. Now, the programming is carried out in PLC software. The software that is popularly used for Siemens PLC is called Semetic Step 7. And we can easily download this software from any browser. Now here we see in the diagram, this is PLC. As I have already told, PLC is a multiple input, multiple output system. So in PLC, we connect number of inputs and number of outputs with the help of this input output card. So here we connect input and here we connect output. It means the machine which is to be controlled by the PLC. Now this machine is controlled with the help of some program which is written in the CPU of the PLC, because PLC is a microprocessor based controlling system. So the user can program PLC with the help of programmable device which is connected externally with the help of Ethernet cable, or also called programming cable. So for programmable device, here we use any laptop or desktop where user can easily program the PLC by using programming software to control any specific task. Now type of PLC programming. Some of the standard programming language of PLC are basically two type, which is further divided into several type. So we can say that basically there are five type of programming languages. These five type is the initial version of IEC standard 611313. This version can support five basic programming languages. These are textual language and the graphical language. There are two type of textual language. First is IL and ST. IL stands for instruction list and ST stands for structure text. Next is graphical language. There are three type of graphical language used in PLC programming. First is ladder logic diagram. Next is functional block diagram, FBD. And third is sequential functional chart. So in this way, there are basically two type of programming language, text textual and graphical. These two is further divided into different type. So textual having two type and graphical having three type. So total basically five basic programming language used in PLC programming. So first is textual language. What do you mean by textual language? In textual language, we write instruction in the form of text. So there are two type of textual language. First is ST, structured text, and second is IL, instruction list. So what do you mean by structured text? Structured text is a block structured language which is based on Pascal. It is a high level language. It is also a text based language. Next is IL, instruction list. The instruction list is a text based and low level language. Next is graphical language. What do you mean by graphical language? In graphical language, we give instruction or we show input and output in the form of graphs. So there are basically three type of graphical language. First is sequential flow chart. Second is functional block diagram. And third is ladder logic diagram. So first is sequential flow chart. As the name suggested, it is just a flow chart. And the sequential flow chart are defined by the function of chart in sequence, just like the block diagram. We can use it if the process can be divided into steps. Okay, next is FBD, functional block diagram. The functions in the functional block diagram are described as the set of elementary blocks. The variables, just like inputs and outputs in the functional block diagram, are connected to block by the lines. Next is ladder logic diagram. Ladder logic diagram is based on Boolean logic operation. This method is very practical, easy to understand, easy to implement. So ladder logic diagram is most popular programming language in PLC. Ladder logic diagram is also known as relay ladder or relay ladder logic diagram. This is based on Boolean logic operation. So in all these programming language, the most commonly used programming language in PLC is ladder logic diagram. So in my next coming video, I will explain you what is ladder logic diagram, how we write program in PLC with the help of ladder logic. So stay continue and keep watching my videos.